What is up, skaters? First of all, ignore the fact that it does look like I'm in a jail. I do film with this background every single week, but someone recently pointed out to me that it looks like I'm in a jail cell, which I'm not. I'm just in the guest room of my home where I live as a almost 22-year-old woman, girl woman. Anyways, today's video is going to be very fulfilling as I will be trying foods from my favorite childhood movies. There's so many. Some of them I cooked myself. Francois Italiano, I'm a cook. And some of them I did buy online. So hopefully they're not laced with anything. Let's begin the tasting. And I also have this nice tablecloth, which is my bed sheet. Now I feel it is indeed appropriate to begin with the ratatouille that I made. It looks just like from the movie.
Ratatouille? They must be joking.
This is a purely vegetarian meal. It is amazing, it's delicious, it's beautiful. Everyone has always wanted to try ratatouille. I'm gonna experience this for you. Or if you want, take a seat, grab a fork, we can share a meal together. I really did outdo myself with this. That rat, Remy, he invented such a beautiful French dish with this. I love it so much. Like the zucchini and the tomato, the little bits of, hold on, rotten black basil that I added for the appearance just give it so much character and such a good flavor. The flavors blend together so well. I love it. I give it a 10 out of 10 simply because ratatouille, baby. It's ratatouille. Anyways, Francois, croissant, je m'appelle Lauren. On to our next tasting. Our next tasting is none other Lotus Flowers from Percy Jackson.
Really signature. Is it good?
That's really good.
Wow, this is the most delicious thing I've ever consumed.
The lotus flower scene, that was the first time I experienced a high of any sort. Just the visuals mixed with the of the late of Poker Face by Lady Gaga. That scene, oh my god, it made me want to go to Vegas and gamble so bad while getting high off of the lotus flowers, which I didn't know what high was at the time. The lotus flowers were definitely laced with something. I did not lace these with anything. They are pure, just meringue. It's egg whites and sugar, that's all these are. Let me show you a close up here. They don't look like flowers. They look like, I'll insert a video of the steps I took while cooking them. Look at them, their peaks. See when your meringue starts peaking, she's a tweaking. Blood, that is so beautiful. That is nature. So, that is not, what is that? That is. Let's try them. Wow. What? Hold up. They even have the crunch that the Percy Jackson ones have. I have this backup thing. I'm gonna do a quick ASMR so you could hear the crunch of these. Whoa. This is really weird. It's like cotton candy. Like, you know how when you eat cotton candy, it dissolves in your mouth? That's what this is doing. It just bite it, and it's dissolving. Wow. And it's healthy because it has egg whites. Excuse me. It has egg whites and just sugar. So you're getting protein and carbohydrates.
Wow.
Next up, we have spinach puffs from Kronk from Emperor's New Groove. Loved that movie.
Something burning?
My spinach puffs. Saved them.
That's great. Good job.
A very good job.
Watch it. They're still hot.
Kronk, the Emperor needs his drink.
Right. Oh, right.
Finally. Good work, Kronk.
Oh, they're so easy to make. I'll get you the recipe.
Kronk was the man. He was a beautiful man that wasn't afraid to show that a man can cook. I just know his spinach puffs slapped so hard. These are actually, I don't know what they are. I got them at Target. I burnt the edges a bit. You could see that close up. Ooh, baby. Do you see it? Focus. Focus. Oh, look at that. I'm actually going to use a fork for these. Still has some ratatouille on it because they're a little oily and I don't want oil on my fingers. This has spinach feta in it. Okay, so right off the bat, I'm getting beautiful flakiness and I know that Kronk's were definitely beautiful and flaky. Here's that bite for ya. Here's that bite for ya. Okay, you know what? Fuck autofocus. Fuck it. Fuck your autofocus. Anyways. Wow, that is so cold. Mmm. Wow. I have never had a spinach puff, but I knew I would like it because I love spinach and I love puffs. No. Another weed joke. Not funny at this point. Don't do drugs. These are actually so delectable. I'm in love. I love them. Mmm. The cheese is the best part. There's also, I taste some maybe like lemon traces. Really good. 10 out of 10 for sure. Everything so far has been a 10 out of 10. Right here, something that was shipped to me from the islands of Hawaii. Authentic. They're authentic. They're beautiful. They are traditional Chinese mooncakes. This is the most excited I've been to try anything in my life. These are from Wendy Wu Homecoming Warrior. I had to improvise as a child to make my life entertaining, and I took on any character in a movie that I liked. I watched that movie every single night at 8, 7 central for perhaps a month straight. I truly believe that I was a Chinese warrior. I took Taekwondo, and I thought that a monk would show up at my door and train me to be the next Wendy Wu homecoming warrior.
Oh my, are these mooncakes?
What are mooncakes?
A very special pastry that is made to celebrate the Chinese Autumn Moon Festival.
Cool, when is that?
Soon.
You haven't made these since I was a kid.
I didn't make them.
Please, I hope you enjoy them.
Mmm, dude, these are good.
I was wearing that beret the entire time, I just realized, so please ignore that. Mooncakes are traditional in the Chinese culture. They are usually made and consumed during the Moon Festival, which I don't know what that is for, but I believe it's for the moon. Look at her in all of her beauty. Oh my God. Look at that beautiful design. Oh, yes. She's so beautiful. Here we go. Mooncake. Oh my God, it even made the same noise that it made in the movie. Oh baby. Oh God, chill. It's chill. It's truly immaculate. The texture is like a Fig Newton. It's like a sweetness that I've never tasted before. Maybe that's because it's black sugar and I've never even heard of black sugar, but I love it. I love it. Oh, fuck. That's so good. That is so good. Truly unbelievable stuff here. I'm going to link the little Hawaiian store that I got these from in the description. Oh God. Next up, these are homemade by me. We have Princess Tiana's beignets. Bring your paintbrush, we're painting the town. Oh, that's the sweetest going round. Get you down in New Orleans. The Princess and the Frog, iconic Disney movie. Tiana's beignets are something that I've wanted to try since the day I saw that movie. The way she poured the honey on and then added the powdered sugar. Oh my God. I've always wanted to go to New Orleans, try the authentic gumbo and the authentic beignets. I really want to go during Mardi Gras and just watch like the drunk, naked people run through the streets. I feel like it would just be invigorating. But until then, I will enjoy my homemade beignets. These were actually fried this afternoon by moi. Pretty much just like a funnel cake, I guess, but a little more doughy because they are dough. Let us enjoy. Here, wait, whoa. Take one. Take a bite. Okay. Cheers to Disney hopefully making their next princess movie starring a black princess, one that does not feature her as a frog for over half of the film. The moistness of this. Oh. I'm having an out-of-body experience because this is so delicious. Dipped in the powdered sugar. Tiana, I can't believe she invented beignets. I just realized that all of these are very culturally rooted dishes slash snacks. And that's really cool because these are things I probably never would have tried if it weren't for the magic of film. Okay. That was delicious. The last dish we will be trying today is none other than Turkish delights from The Chronicles of Narnia, The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe.
Anything you'd like to eat? Turkish delight? Edmund? Very much like to meet the rest of your family.
Why? They're nothing special.
Probably one of the most watched movies of my childhood. Watch that all the goddamn time. I could recite it word for word, start to finish. Lucy Pevensey, pizza. I always was in love with Edmonds. Maybe that's where my obsession with British men came from. Okay, so Turkish delights in the movie looked so impeccable, but I've heard that they're actually disgusting because it's just like gelatin with a little bit of powdered sugar, but the ones in the movie looked like fluffy. But I got these off of Amazon. I'll link them below as well if you guys want to try them. I'll link everything that I bought below if you guys want to try it. I feel like they might not be very good, but I'm going to stay positive. Those are Turkish delights, baby. Oh my God. Edmund, cheers to Turkish delights. Now that tastes like soap. What is that? I've tasted soap better than that. I was so sad that they really hyped them up like that in Narnia, and that's how they tasted like. But the inside is beautiful. It really does taste like a Yankee Candle covered in powdered sugar that is also a little uncomfortably gelatinous. Maybe I'll return them. And with that being said, guys, that was the end of this little tasting of my childhood movie foods. That was such a fun video. I love laid back videos and I also love food. And I love cooking, and I love experiencing new things, and I love broadening my horizons, and I don't know, I guess I'm just different. This was very intimate, I feel. I feel like we went on a date together. I feel like we went on a date, me and you, and we tried a bunch of new stuff. Kind of cute, I don't know. Let me know if you want me to do a part two to this, because I have a list of foods that I would love to try, maybe like from childhood TV shows or just like other movies. Thank you so much for watching. If you are not subscribed, subscribe perhaps. Make sure to turn on post notifications, because YouTube stays being a little bitch and doesn't tell you when I upload unless you have notifications on. I'm gonna link my Twitch under here, because I'm gonna start going live on Twitch and just chatting, because I don't know, I'm bored and I want to talk to somebody. An ounce of affection, please. Anyways, I will see you guys next time. Bye, love you.